Most Asian markets headed south as investors digested Chinese economic data that failed to impress. China's manufacturing for May expanded moderately, based on both the official PMI, which gives more weight to larger state-owned companies, and the private Taishin Index, which focuses more on smaller private manufacturers. Meanwhile, the services sector, which accounts for more than half of China's economy, contracted for the 15th consecutive month. Stocks in the mainland lost 0.1%, while those in Hong Kong shed 0.25%. The Nikkei 225 slipped big time as the yen strengthened, hurting Japanese exporters, and as reports a sales tax hike program for 2017 will be delayed until 2019 raised concerns about Japan's ability to handle its debt load. Here at home, it was a different story. The PSEi index settled at the 7,500 mark, a two-week high, as foreign investors turned net buyers. Philippine shares raced out of the gates, outperforming their Asian peers on the first trading day of the month. Still powering the rally, telco giants, which were involved in a mega deal that surprised many earlier this week. PLDT jumped to an over two-month high, while Globe Telecom finished at its highest level in 9 months. Well, Fitch on Tuesday said it was upbeat about Globe and PLDT buying San Miguel's telco business, Moody's is not as optimistic, especially on PLDT. It says the acquisition is credit negative for PLDT as it pushes the firm to the upper end of leverage tolerance for its rating at a time when its operating performance is under pressure. For BPI Securities' Jomar Lacson, the deal didn't really change anything, except it did allow San Miguel to cash in on idle assets.
It doesn't really change our view over the sector, because at the end of the day, the third player did not really materialize. So what you have is still PLDT and Globe, and they'll have to still fight for market share. And I think the expectations there are still that that has an impact on their margins.
Meanwhile, other blue chips that helped the PSEi buck the regional slump, Meralco, SM Investments, ICTSI, Banco de Oro, and Ayala Land. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.